you going to do?
Publish them after the war.
Aye, I'm right at that.
Yeah, well, posthumous collections always sell better. Your best hope's to die young.
Any good?
No, it's just a novel.
I don't know why I said that. It's not just a novel. It's The Good Soldier by Ford Madox Ford.
Yes, it's all about how he built the Model T and found true happiness.
Madox Ford. I thought that was...
He's kidding you. He's kidding. I can see you're a literary man.
Well, what's it about? About the army, is it?
No, it's about passion, really.
Passion?
Yes, you know, the stuff they inject you against when you join up.
Why don't you tell them the story?
I don't read fiction. Fiction's for shop girls.
Well, you should know all about them. I understand you scored your greatest successes at Woolworths. No, it's really a very good book. It's about people who destroy themselves for love in one way or another.
Sounds like hot stuff.
Not really. It's more like a horror story, like Muir over there.
There are so many unattractive aspects to a command such as mine. May I speak now as a fellow officer? I did not join the army to become part of a prison service. But be that as it may, I am here and responsible not only for the prisoners in my charge, but also for preserving that slender line known as the status quo. You follow me, Colonel. That being so, I have to exercise my judgment in matters not covered by the book of rules we all live by. I have here a letter from England, addressed to one of your officers. It has, of course, been opened and read by my censor, but because of the contents, he brought it to my personal attention.
It is bad news, I take it.
Yes, yes, I think so. Or it would be to most men. The sort of news which might make a man desperate. Top of the second page, Colonel.
I see him. Come in. Hey, Phil.
Sir, you wanted to see me?
Yes, I did. I'm sorry to bother you.
Oh, that's okay. You got me out of a lousy poker game. I've been drawing four cards to a straight flush all day.
Sit down, won't you? You know, I am not quite sure why I sent for you. It's probably some misguided conception of the American character. The thing is, I have a problem which normally I should be able to deal with, but I don't seem to be making much headway with it. Of course, you're not married, are you?
No, sir. Not in the sight of God.
No, I didn't think you were. I have some very bad news to break to one of our officers, Lieutenant MacDonald. Do you know him?
Yeah, slightly. He's a bit touchy, you know. He's gotten on me about GI pay a couple of times.
Oh, yes, that sounds like MacDonald, right? He came up through the ranks, you know. And the British War Office have always considered that the privilege of dying is enough in itself without being paid very much for it. This is a letter for MacDonald, and it contains some very bad news. It's what you would call, I think, a Dear John letter. Now, under normal circumstances, it is my duty and my privilege to break that news to him. But I've considered it very carefully, and I don't think that I should do this one. So I thought of you.
Couldn't the Padre do it?
Well, no, I don't think so. See, if I'm any judge of character, MacDonald is going to find it even harder to take from the Padre than he would from me.
Well, Colonel, I hardly know MacDonald.
Well, exactly. That's all to the good, isn't it? Bad news is often easier coming from strangers, wouldn't you agree?
Yes, sir.
MacDonald around?
No idea.
Come and take some exercise, Phil. Getting flabby.
Yeah, how about some stool ball?
Stool ball? What are you talking about? The last time I played with you guys, I broke my back.
Well, we'll try and break your nose this time.
Come on. Hey, is MacDonald around?
I think you'll find him in the bowl.
Nick?
MacDonald?
Aye.
You're not playing either, huh?
No.
You're not sick, are you?
Nope.
Everybody seems to be coming down with something. Finish that book.
No, I'm not a great reader.
Well, it's a pretty good book when you once get into it. I'll leave it for you anyway. I've got some news for you. You got a letter.
What are you on about? I've just been to the mailroom.
Yeah, well, this one came via the commandant to Colonel Preston, and he asked me to give it to you.
Why you?
Well, that's what I asked him. He thought I'd make it easy.
Do you know what's in it?
Yeah, I do. It's a Dear John letter.
Who told you?
Well, Colonel Preston. He had to read it.
Read it for me.
Now, you go ahead and read it. I'll be back in a few minutes.
I'd thank you if you would.
It's your letter.
Read it! Please.
My dear Ian, as you know, I'm not much of a hand at writing, and as you will see, I'm sending this from a new address. This is Molly's place. Molly is a friend of mine from work, and she's been a friend in more ways than one. Oh, my dear, I wish I were with you. I wish I were with you there, and I wish I could write the proper words and say that I didn't mean to bring you any extra sorrow in that place you're at, and if you were here with me, everything would be different. But you're not, and what I have to write is that I am having a barren by another man, and it wasn't anybody's fault but mine. But I will always understand if you never want to see me or it ever again, so we'll close now with asking you not to worry over much and forgive me for this letter and everything. If I could bear your pain, I should be happy, and Love always, Alice. Sorry.
Don't be sorry. What's there to be sorry about? It's what the bloody war's about, isn't it? Freedom!
We're in cells. She and me. All of us. I'm in here. And she's in a bloody prison, a house without a man. She made a break for it, that's all. Went over the wall. Jumped the wire.
Come in. All right?
Yes, sir. I gave him the letter.
How did he take it?
Well, he was very upset.
That's what he's bound to be, isn't he? Do you think he can cope?
Oh, yes. I think he'll go quietly mad like the rest of us around here.
Well, keep an eye on him for me for the next few days, will you, Phil?
Yes, sir. Good night.
Good night.
Can you lend me 5 pfennigs? I'm out of that Mickey Mouse money to get us.
5? God's gone up.
Just pay the man, would you?
Now, come on, meow.
Can I talk to you?
Sure, mate.
Got a minute?
Sure.
In private.
Okay, let's go and find someone.
How you feeling?
Great, feeling great. No problems.
Okay, what can I do for you?
Well, did you hear I got a letter?
Yes, I did.
Hmm. Well, you see, as I look at it, she had no bloody choice in the matter. I mean, well, I can't expect you to ken her as well as I do just by talking about her, but if it was nothing, I mean, if she didn't care, she'd not have bothered writing at all. You understand what I'm saying?
Of course.
So as I see it, she wasn't just asking me for forgiveness, but to do something. I mean, I'm the man. I'm the man of the house. Not only that, I've been bloody trained to do something.
Now, what you're saying is that if you were there, you could do something about
it. Exactly. The first thing I do is put one on him. That's the way we sort things out where I come from. Be it Celtic versus Rangers or the milkman delivering 1 or 2 pints too many.
Yeah, well, I'm sure you're right.
I know I'm right. But hear me out a while. It sounds sort of corny, but neither of us have had anybody else, you know. I mean, she's got no real family. They're slag like mine. I've got a couple of pips up and I'm an officer and a gentleman for the duration, but don't let's kid ourselves. You see, well, I've always known she couldn't fend for herself without me. Now, that's the crux of the matter here. Now, the important thing now is that I've got to get back to her. That's what I've decided. I've got to get out of here and back to her.
Yes, well, obviously that would be the perfect solution.
Now, that's right. So what I'm asking you is, well, it's when?
Well, you know as well as I do that there's procedure.
Ach, I know all that, but this is no ordinary request. This is different. He knows that.
Well, I can sympathize with you, yes, but it's not up to me alone.
Oh, but your word would count.
Well, I don't think it would count that much.
Oh, but you'll put it forward, though, won't you?
Yes, I'll put it forward.
Aye, and you'll push it.
I'll do what I can.
Aye, I know. I've every confidence that you will. Now, you see, that's why I feel so much better in myself. I've made a decision. That's half the battle, don't you agree?
Obviously, sir, I would have tried to reason with him, but he's made up his mind. He sees the whole thing quite crystal clear. He's going to get out of here, and somehow I'm going to be able to get him at the top of the list.
Well, that's out of the question. I hope you told him that.
No, more or less.
What do you mean, more or less?
Well, sir, he wasn't being very rational. I mean, we're dealing with a not very articulate man who's just suffered a tremendous emotional blow.
Well, maybe he has, but that doesn't justify him going to the top of the queue.
Well, I suppose we could say with some validity that certain categories are to be given priority. MacDonald, being special commander unit, comes under that heading.
right even accepting that. I mean, we don't even have an escape going at the moment, do we?
No, sir, nothing ahead of the French.
That means you're going to have to talk to the French, and I can't see them being very impressed with your reasons.
No, I don't think they will be very impressed, but I think we owe it to him morally to put it to them.
And I think you'll be turned down. Just tell me honestly, Pat, as the escape officer, do you really think you're justified in putting him to the top of the queue?
Yes, sir. Not just for his sake, but for everybody's sake.
All right, you better go and have a chat to the French, hadn't you?
Non! Impossible! There is no point in having a selection committee, a method of deciding the order of release, if we are going to change it. Just because you are supposed to give some men special priority. We also have our instructions. And our instructions are not to ask for favors, but to get out.
I understand.
I'm sorry for this man. But the rules are yours as much as ours. It's our turn. The scheme is ours. It's been approved by the Joint Committee. And the two men who thought of it have priority, obviously.
I appreciate that. And I'm fully aware of the extent of the favor I asked. But I had to ask it.
Good. Well, you have asked it, and I've given our answer.
In mitigation, we felt that there were exceptional extenuating circumstances.
Wait. If somebody wants to jump the queue, those are the exceptional mitigating circumstances.
But I don't accept it. You had every confidence you were going to fix it for.
No, you had the confidence. I merely said that I would make an attempt on your behalf, which I did. I went to the French, and they said no. There's an end to it.
Well, they weren't going to hand it to us on a plate. It needed a bit of a push. I mean, you're the escape officer, it's your pigeon. I wasn't just asking you to go in there and swap a few bars of my chocolate ration. I was asking you to go in there and plead as hard as you know how for what you both know is my wife and my marriage.
Well, MacDonald, I don't think this is a very rewarding conversation. We understand.
I don't consider that this is near conversation.
You will, nevertheless, do me the courtesy of hearing me out. We understand your problem, and we are not without sympathy for it. The fact remains that the only grounds for appeal have been properly put, forcefully put, and turned down.
How the hell do I know they were forcefully put? Because I say so! If you think being escape officer is a plum job in this lousy place, then you're very much mistaken.
I didn't say that.
No, you implied that I merely went through the motion.
All I'm saying is...
Shut.
All I'm saying is you both know what was in that letter.
Yes, we do. The fact is that it looks as if you have lost your wife. Now, I understand that probably more than you realize. But in spite of Captain Grant's efforts, the answer is no, and you are going to have to find the moral courage to live with that.
Sir.
Yes or no?
No.
Not even considering it?
No. You can't blame them either. They've been at it for 2 months. It's a pretty wild scheme.
How many men are there?
Two.
Do we know who they are?
Yes, I know.
Well, I thought that maybe a direct approach, if one of us could talk to them personally, we...
Well, I'll have to think about that.
Yeah, well, let me know, because I could do some talking.
Yes, I'll let you know.
We haven't got anything coming up.
No, we haven't. Nothing ahead of the French.
I feel sorry for him.
Well, you shouldn't.
Yeah, I know I shouldn't. But I do, and that's a fact. And we live by the facts.
How you doing?
Fine, I'm doing fine. Well, I've been reading this book you lent me.
Oh, yeah? How do you like it?
Well, it's a wee bit heavy going to begin with. Well, to me it was, but then I haven't read many books, proper books. Most I ever read was the Hotspur and the Magnet, on Sexton, Blake, and Tinker, of course. You heard of them?
No. I was brought up on Nancy Drew, girl detective. You ever hear of her? Oh, well, Nancy Drew used to solve everything. She probably still does. We could do with a little bit of Nancy Drew around here in more ways than one.
There's one bit in this book. I hear. Here were two noble natures drifting down life like fire ships afloat on a lagoon and causing miseries, heartaches, agony of the mind and death. And why? For what purpose? To point what lesson? It is all a darkness.
He makes it come alive, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does. He's a good writer.
Like fire ships afloat on a lagoon. That's a bit I like. He was here, a soldier himself.
Yeah. He was in the trenches in the First World War.
He must have been. It says somewhere else that all good soldiers are sentimentalists. But he doesn't make judgments, does he? He doesn't blame. I think it's important not to blame anybody.
Yeah, me too.
Bravo. Can we talk?
Good, yes. What would you like to talk about? The weather? Monsieur Roosevelt? Paris in the spring?
Catapults.
No. I never learned that subject at school.
What about Louis?
Oh, he's very limited. He only has two interests, sex and food. Not necessarily in that order.
Well, that suits me. You know how us Americans are. We have an opinion on everything.
Now, I don't think that would work either.
Why don't you think it would work?
The Croissant here is only concerned with the practical aspect of his two favorite subjects. He never discussed theory.
Well, that suits me. We think alike. I'd like to catapult you into some really deep thinking that would lead to something practical.
Come to our courthouse.
My pleasure. It's the first time I've ever been propositioned by a Frenchman.
What's it about?
Well, Captain Grant told me about your escape plan. I'll put it to you very simply. We have a man who wants to get out of here in a hurry.
Who doesn't?
Yeah. I just felt that, well, we know it's your plan and we know we have no rights, but I owe it to this man to ask.
Ask what?
Well, to ask if you'd strike a bargain, give up one man in your plan and we'll cut you in on our next one.
What sort of bargain is that?
It's a lousy one.
Exactly. So what else shall we talk about?
Well, you might ask why I had the nerve to come here and ask you in the first place.
Yes. We'll hear your reason.
Can I sit down?
Please.
Oh. Are either of you married?
No. Well, Francois.
Well, this man that we have in mind got a Dear John letter. You know what that is?
No.
Well, it covers a wide field. In this particular case, he got a letter from his wife saying that she was pregnant. Another man.
He is pregnant.
All sent.
You understand?
Well,
see, he feels that if he can get back to her soon, very soon, he won't lose her. Now, he believes that.
Well, that's sad for him, huh?
Yeah. Now, see, Captain Grant went to your escape officer and he got a turndown. And I thought that if I came to you personally and if you understood the circumstances, that you might possibly consider the fact that...
No! It's not possible. We are all together, prisoner. Like yourself, huh? Like your unfortunate friend.
Yeah, that's true. Thanks very much. Good luck.
Haven't we any plan?
No, nothing that'll help McDonald. Downing and Muir have come up with an idea.
They have?
Mm-hmm.
Is it any good? Do you think it'll work?
I think it's very good, but they can't start till the French go.
When are the French set to go?
Oh, they've been at it 2 months. They've got another 5 weeks.
Well, can't they move it up?
Well, that plan depends on an exact second on a particular night. I could try to get him in with Downing and Muir.
Yeah, that won't help McDonald. He wants to get back there before that baby's born.
Well, presumably he can write a letter before then.
Yeah, he writes letters all the time. He never posts them.
What do you mean?
He just puts them in a tin box underneath his bunk. I haven't seen him post a letter yet.
Captain Grant, my companion and I have given further thought to the proposition of Lieutenant Carrington. In the special circumstance, we have decided to accept.
Accept? That's wonderful.
That's great.
It's not wonderful.
It is merely a decision.
Who made the decision?
I have decided.
You? Aren't you the married one? Why you?
Lieutenant Carrington, it's obvious from our previous conversation that you have a very limited knowledge of Frenchmen. That obviously extends to marriage, huh? French marriage in particular.
There has also been a letter. Did we?
Oh, wait. I too have had a letter, huh? A dear Francois letter. My wife, I regret to say, is in good spirit, but my mistress is living with a German sergeant.
Look, Phil, if a man tells you he can't walk because he has just broken his leg, you're inclined to believe him, no?
Yeah.
Why don't we just leave it like that? You'll be doing me a great favor if you will eventually get me to England.
Yes, of course. When would you like to see our man?
As soon as possible.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you. Good luck.
Merci.
What do you think?
He's lost his nerve, hasn't he?
All clear.
I'll leave you to it.
Which one do I thank?
Please. Much to learn, eh? Very little time. That is Louis. He's the one who's going with you. You must do everything that he tells you, eh? The first thing, have you a good head for height?
What do you think these are? They're not ready Scotch mist, you know.
Oh, son.
Oh, it's bloody mad. That's what's so beautiful about it. So mad, it's got to work.
You feel good about it?
Oh, I'm on top of the world, literally. But I can't stop now. We're practicing all the time.
Allez, knees. Remember, bend the knees when you land.
Aye, aye, aye.
Attention. Dix, neuf, huit, sept, six, cinq, quatre, trois, deux, un.
Hey, you know, it's going to be dark when we do this.
Good, good.
We thought we'd like to make our contribution, so we made up these.
Possibly too heavy. I'll have to consult with the others.
Well, they're yours if you need them. We've put some extra men on the rope making. Some of the material we were using didn't survive the test.
On the new papers?
They'll be ready. Anything else you need?
Polish. We need more polish.
I'll put George Brent onto that. He makes a first-class polish. He's in the Guards. How's the new recruit coming along?
He'd be perfect if he could speak English.
Right. Now!
Okay.
Relax.
Right, next bit. Cinq, quatre, trois, deux, now!
Steif ist höchste Zeit, dass du hier kommst.
Fifty-nine seconds tonight.
And what are you working to?
The change of guard coincides with a short, blind period at dusk, just before the searchlights are switched on. We've been timing these changes every night for 3 months. There's never been more than 60 seconds and never less than 57.
So that the maximum period of darkness...
You mean the maximum period of maximum darkness?
Yes.
It's 57 seconds to be on the safe side.
And then the searchlights come on.
It's not long to accomplish what we have to in the time.
Here, take this straight. Ready?
Wasn't it bad?
No, not bad. Let's try it again.
I just told you the reason.
We've all got reasons.
Look, the decision's been made. MacDonald's going, and that's it.
So in our next scheme, we've got to give up a place to a Frenchman.
That's right.
I see.
Tomorrow night or never, eh, Pat?
That's right.
Do they need a diversion?
No, they've already got one set.
Only as a last resort. They prefer nothing.
How do you rate it?
I think it's an amazing idea. Their preparations have been very thorough. They've left nothing to chance.
MacDonald, is he okay?
Yeah, he's in good shape.
Money?
Not enough, I think. Food for 3 days if he doesn't gorge himself.
There's a weight factor. Weather. Is that critical?
No. Not unless there's a high wind. I think they're okay. I hope it works for him. Well, for both of them, really.
Yes, I hope so, too.
Especially MacDonald. He's got a lot to get home for.
Yes, I suppose he has.
Everything goes to those who push, I'm told.
Yes. But I knew a chap once who went on a tremendously long journey, only to find, when he got home, someone else's pack hanging up in the hall.
Gefangene! Abtreten!
Might help.
Three minutes,
take your places.
Une minute. Dix, neuf, huit, cinq, quatre, trois, deux, go!
Is los.
Cinquante-sept.
Was ist los?
Ich weiß nicht.
Was
hab da ganz bestimmt was gehört.
Ja, mir ist es auch so vorgekommen.
Alarm, Wache raus! Alarm! Alarm! Scheinwerfer Richtung 9.
Too much.
Well, let's crawl to the end.
Fünf Mann, runter zum Grab! Los, los, marsch, marsch!
On. Go! I'll manage.
They must have done it by now.
Und wieder rüber.
Go, Mighty, what you come back for, man?
For you, for
go,
you.
Go, go,
for
God's sake, go.
Which one? Brilliant, Colonel. You are undoubtedly expecting me to congratulate you. You have now achieved your ambition. A man, an officer under your command, has been killed. It's a victory for common sense, It's a valuable contribution to the British war effort, and one less mouth to feed here in Colditz. But do not make the mistake that I have brought you before me to play the headmaster to one of your public school games. Because that is what your behavior to date suggests, that war is a game. That you can play and break the rules and your word merely to satisfy your misguided sense of honor.
The only difference between your games and the real facts of life is that we use real bullets. So now you can bury your dead and prepare yourself for your next game, which may not be played with me, but with members of the SS. I do not even pity you, Colonel. I cannot pity fools. You may go. Yes. Well,
the prisoner de Croissant has not been recaptured, sir.
Get me the senior French officer immediately. I want the French and the British quarters searched. Thoroughly! You understand?
Yes, sir.
Find out how they did it!
Yes, sir, Commandant.
Je vous, monsieur! Sortez de vos lits! Allez vous rassembler dans la cour. Comme je vous dis, j'ai mérité. Attention! Everyone out of here, in the courtyard. Suchen Sie mir die Baracke da durch. Hier. Kommen Sie mit.
If anything should happen to me, I want you to find somebody else and be happy with him. I can't put it into words any more than you can. And I'm sorry I haven't been a very good husband or a very good soldier. The important thing is not to blame anybody. I haven't learnt much, but I have learnt that.
We have discovered those responsible, sir.
I'll see them in the morning. I'll get rid of these. Take those. See that they get directly to the next of kin. There's nothing of importance in them. Good night, Hauptmann Nummer.
Good night, Commander.